Hi everyone, thanks for checking back in for another episode of Says the Vet. We're up to that time of year now where our naturally reared lambs on mums in the paddock are getting ready to wean here in New Zealand, so a lot of questions around when to vaccinate. And your hand-reared bubs, you've probably beaten me to it, but I wanted to put the info out there because people get so confused with conflicting information online. The reason it's so conflicting online is because it depends how the lamb is being reared and the management of its mum, as well as its backstory a little bit. So let's jump into it, break it down into easy categories for you so you know where you fit in. So let's start with the naturally reared lambs drinking from mum out in the paddock. If the mother has had a booster vaccination a month out from lambing, the lamb will be protected for the first 3 months or so of life. So in this case, you're going to give the first vaccine to the lambs at about 3 months old. On farms, this is usually the time they're being weaned, so you're usually line weaning up with your vaccinations. They need a booster 4 weeks later. Ideally, they have a yearly booster as well. And if they're breeding girls, you'll want to line this yearly booster up with 4 weeks out from her own birthing to protect her baby, so the cycle continues. But it's important to note, guys, that this is not just a mother that has been vaccinated. It's not even a mother that has had a yearly booster and is fully up to date. It is a mother that has very specifically had her booster 4 weeks out from lambing. And this is because on this schedule, we can expect the antibodies in her blood, which are the immune cells specifically built to fight off that disease, we can expect those antibodies to be peaking really high in the blood 4 weeks after vaccination at the time of labor. And that's when her body is creating colostrum for that new lamb. Colostrum is the milk produced in the first 2 to 3 days after the lamb has been born. Really, really high in antibodies, so immune cells. She's passing on her immune system to the lamb, okay? Now the other assumption that we're making with this is that the bub is doing well, that he had a normal birth, and that he stood and drank a good amount of colostrum from a healthy mother shortly after birth, within the first 4 to 6 hours. So if the ewe was sick, if she didn't have the milk to give, or if the lamb was sick or hurt on the way out, or for whatever reason, weak and lethargic, and didn't stand to drink within the first 4 to 6 hours, then it does not matter how well vaccinated the mother was, that's not going to be passed down to the bub, all right? So in this case, these little ones are gonna fit into the orphans category, which we'll come back to in a minute. So when lambs reared on the mother, on the ewe, but the mum did not have a booster 4 weeks out, you'll want to give a tetanus antitoxin shot at the time of tail docking and castration, which really should be in the first couple of weeks of life, up to the first 3 weeks. And that's to keep pain to a minimum. We want to do our ring castrations and tail docking, really, the younger the better. Allow a few days for colostrum intake and bonding at the start of life. But other than that, really, if you can get it done at 1 week old, that's fantastic, because pain's going to be a real minimum at that point. So yes, they're going to need an antitoxin injection, which usually comes in a combination with a vaccine against pulpy kidney, and you give this as soon as you're creating a wound. So if you're docking them, putting the rings on at 2 weeks old, that's when you start that, okay? And then they fall back in line with their vaccinations at about 3 months old. That's for those raised on mum, but the mum wasn't vaccinated. Okay, so our third category, what if they're not being raised on mum at all? Or they had a rough start, our little orphans. If a lamb or kid has been orphaned, mum had no milk to give, for example, it was a little one born into a storm, or even just unfortunately the littlest triplet, which often don't get a look in at feeding time, we need to assume that these guys are immunocompromised and are not inheriting a good immunity from mum. Even if you manage to get a quality store-bought colostrum into them, it's not going to be teeming with those antibodies at peak levels against the diseases that we're vaccinating against, okay? So certainly you still want to get that colostrum into them, absolutely. That'll just protect them in general. So you definitely get that into them in any way you can, but we also need to go ahead and start vaccinating them younger than we normally would. Now that vaccination is usually given along with the antitoxin shot at the time of docking. So if we are creating a wound of any kind by putting the ring on the tail of lambs or the testicles, ear tagging, that wound is going to create a really high risk time. So we start the vaccination course early if they're fully immunocompromised. So some of our vaccinations that we have available now are actually labelled for use from 2 weeks old, which is really handy. Some of the more traditional ones are labelled for use from 4 to 6 weeks old, but we usually pull that forward a little bit, okay? And if you're having an outbreak of something on your farm, or if you've got a really immunocompromised little one that needs to have his vaccination started really early, you might even add in a third booster before going to your yearly ones. Okay, so the point of this episode was to try and clarify that. I hope it was clear. I feel like maybe I just confused things even more. Hopefully that helped somewhat. Don't forget to thumbs up, comment, let me know if you found it useful, and subscribe to catch more like it. I will see you for the next one. Bye-bye.